Hello and welcome to the Magic of Mathematics channel. My name is Manohar Murthy and you are watching one amongst a series of videos exploring the world of mathematics. In this video, I will be dealing with multiplications involving a fraction and a natural number. If you are looking for answers to questions like what does it mean to multiply a fraction and a natural number, or how do I intuitively understand the process or rules used for performing multiplications involving a fraction and a natural number, then you should see this video. In this video, I assume that you have an understanding of what a fraction is, what are the different kinds of fractions, and how to add two fractions. If you're interested in exploring multiplications involving two fractions instead, then you should see the video that I have created on that topic. Now that we know what we will be looking at in this video, let us dive right in. When we want to look at multiplications involving a fraction and a natural number, there are various cases possible, as the fraction involved could be a proper fraction, an improper fraction, or a mixed fraction. In this video, I will look at two cases, namely a natural number times a proper fraction and a proper fraction times a natural number. An example of the first case is 2 times 1 by 3, and an example of the second case is 3 by 8 times 2. I will use these two examples to illustrate the two cases that I will be taking up. From this point onwards, I will be using NN to refer to a natural number and PF to refer to a proper fraction. Further, I will be using NUM and DENOM to refer to the numerator and denominator of a fraction. To begin with, let us look at the first case, namely a natural number times a proper fraction. This happens to be the easiest one to conceptualize. Let us write the example that we took on, namely 2 times 1 by 3. To understand this multiplication problem better, let us take a small digression here into the world of natural numbers. When we deal with natural numbers, one way we are used to looking at multiplication is to think of it as repeated addition. For example, 2 times 4 would be 4 added to itself, which we know to be 8. If we extend this reasoning to the problem that we are looking at, namely, what is 2 times 1 by 3? We can say that 2 times 1 by 3 is nothing but 1 by 3 added to itself, which if we know how to add two fractions, we know the answer would be 2 by 3. We can also think about this problem in a visual way. Let us do that now. We will look at the same example as before, namely 2 times 1 by 3. We know that 1 by 3 is one piece of something. Say the thing we are talking about is a chocolate. This piece having been obtained by cutting the chocolate into 3 equal pieces. We know that 2 times 1 piece equal to 2 pieces. And since the piece size has not changed, this is equivalent to 2 by 3. Thus, we have shown visually that 2 times 1 by 3 equals 2 by 3. Now let us summarize the learnings from our first case. For our example problem, namely 2 times 1 by 3, our answer turned out to be a fraction whose numerator is 2 times 1 and whose denominator is 3. Hence, we can see that a natural number times a proper fraction yields a fraction whose numerator is obtained by multiplying the natural number with the numerator of the original fraction and whose denominator is the same as the denominator of the original fraction. Now, let us turn our attention to the second case. The second case that we will be looking at in this video is that of a proper fraction times a natural number. Let us look at the example that we took on, namely 3 by 8 times 2. We can see that it is difficult to look at multiplication as repeated addition, as the addition of 2 to itself 3 by 8 times doesn't seem to make much sense. If we make use of the knowledge that multiplication is commutative, then we can say that 3 by 8 times 2 is equivalent to 2 times 3 by 8. And since we already know how to find out what is 2 times 3 by 8, we can easily find out what is 3 by 8 times 2. But the big question is whether multiplication involving fractions is commutative. We know that multiplication of two natural numbers is commutative. But let us consider that we don't know yet whether the same holds true when multiplying a natural number and a fraction. So the original question remains, namely, what does it mean when we say a proper fraction times a natural number? And how do we perform this operation? Let us look at what our example, namely 3 by 8 times 2 means. Let us assume that the 2 in this case refers to 2 chocolates. Just like 2 times 2 is the quantity of chocolate that 2 people can consume, we can think of 3 by 8 times 2 as the quantity of chocolate consumed by someone who is capable of consuming only 3/8 of what a normal person can consume. Let us call this person as a 3/8 person. What this means is that for every 8 chocolates that a normal person can consume, the 3/8 person can consume 3 chocolates. We can also say that if a normal person can consume 8 pieces of chocolate, this person can consume only 3 pieces. For determining the quantity of chocolate that this 3/8 person can consume, we cut the first chocolate into 8 equal size pieces and then the second chocolate into 8 equal size pieces. We then take 3 pieces from each chocolate, and now it is clear that we will end up with 3 times 2 pieces of chocolate. Notice that the piece size has not changed. That is, we are still talking about pieces of the size obtained by cutting a chocolate into 8 equal size pieces. Hence, our answer is 3 times 2 by 8. Let us now look at our second case one last time. We saw that 3 by 8 times 2 is equal to a fraction whose numerator is 3 times 2 and whose denominator is 8. Hence, we can say that a proper fraction times a natural number yields a fraction whose numerator is equal to the numerator of the original fraction times the natural number, and whose denominator is equal to the denominator of the original fraction. We are done with both the cases now. In this video, we looked only at multiplications involving a natural number and a proper fraction. I would like to mention that using appropriate examples and similar reasoning, we can arrive at a similar process for multiplications involving a natural number and other kinds of fractions as well. I hope you found this video helpful. Thanks for watching.